Now, I just said, don't be silly. This is serious.
Just studying up on the message Sunday at church, I actually thought about getting up and walking out in the very beginning. Cross point recovery. Broken, then restored relationships. Evaluate our relationship.
There you go.
Offer forgiveness to those who've hurt us and make amends for harm we've done to others, except when to do so would harm them or others.
There you go.
John. You know, I just feel so much better being resentful, though.
Jamie, I knew when I was preaching this message that I was going to hear about this message on Wednesday morning.
Getting started.
Yeah. I said what Jamie is talking about. I said, I've never met anybody who sits around and says, I feel so much better being resentful. Except for maybe Jamie Cooper. That's right.
But you know,
most of us don't feel better being resentful.
We were even talking about you at Dr. Child's, at the cancer doctor the other day, about you, because Sharon there goes to church with us.
She sings in the
choir. She's the nurse.
Yeah. Right.
And she was talking, man, she said, this was so good. But you know, John, you got a couple things in here. I mean, I've got a bitter root.
Yeah, I do.
Yeah, you do.
Who can I poison?
Well, boy,
Everyone around you.
Sounds like my ex-wife, one of them.
We're talking about you.
There is so much truth in that. You know what I said, too, on Sunday morning? I guarantee you so many people came into our church Sunday morning because it's just human nature. Many of us have a bitter root. We're bitter towards somebody. And that bitter root, you know, will defile many. A lot of our relationships, a lot of our families, a lot of our situations, a lot of otherwise possibly good relationships are defiled because of a bitter root that we haven't gotten over. And boy, when you live with bitterness towards somebody, it can affect other relationships all the time.
You know, I guess the number one thing that got me in there.
There was one?
No, yeah. Make a list of people who've hurt you. You know what, John? Make a list of people who've hurt you. Let's see here.
Here we go.
That's what he was doing this morning.
Make a list of those people. Huh? Make a list of those people. I'm not finished.
Oh, yeah.
Who hurt you? John.
Oh, Jamie, you are too much.
Oh, Jamie.
Now that I got my list, what am I supposed to do? You don't know what these people have done to me.
I understand.
The money.
I understand that.
The lies.
It's
all in court. We got it all.
Right. Well,
God wants me to forgive all these people.
All I know is my job is to be the messenger. And he says, forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And
anybody ever owed you?
I know there's something you need to be forgiven for.
John? People carry a grudge.
Boy, that's the truth. That is the truth.
I do. Don't mind admitting it right here. Yes, I do. And will I forgive them? Probably not.
Right. I understand.
I mean, I'm just going to be quite honest. Truth is, the truth shall set me free.
No, you're in trouble.
Huh?
You're a moron.
There are some people but I don't care. When you say something about the bridges, I'll blow bridges up.
Yeah, right. Don't blow your bridges up. Right. That's right.
Don't burn bridges.
Well, do understand. I do want to make one clarification, and probably should have addressed it more on Sunday. Forgiveness is a command. Restoration is a whole different matter. You know, I can forgive somebody, and I need to forgive somebody because positionally before Christ, it doesn't mean that they need to become my best friend again or anything such as that. So make sure, when I talk about forgiveness, like I said, listen, if somebody were to embezzle money from the church, we would forgive them, but we're not going to appoint them back to the finance committee anytime soon. You know, that's one of those kind of situations. If somebody abuses your child, well, you know, you find some way in your heart to have some kind of forgiveness, but you're not going to put them around your kids anytime soon. You know, so that's pretty much what I'm talking about.
Did that make sense to you, Mr. Cooper?
We'll discuss this further.
Yes,
John, when I bring out a list like that, and, you know, you dealt with jerks or whatever all my life, you know, a lot of them in TV business, other ones, but how do you let it go?
Well, the only way you let it go is you go to the Lord and you say, Lord, you have forgiven me, then I must forgive them. And what I said the other day, humanly, it's not possible. you know, I can't will this up. I can't will this up in my mind. And it's, if I depend on my own willpower, I'll never make it. But I do depend and ask the Holy Spirit of God inside of us, which is what happens when we become Christians. That's the only way that you can do any of this stuff, because all this stuff is poppycock outside of the power of the Holy Spirit. It's not normal. It's not human. It's not real. But Jesus in you allows you to have forgiveness that you otherwise wouldn't have had, and just all kind of things that wouldn't normally be. It's because of the power of Christ in you.
Well, okay. You said, if you want to go with that.
So you say.
So you say.
So you say. Yes.
Hey, Corey.
You know,
take a shot of that empty chair over there. Where? Right, just take a shot of an empty chair.
There you go.
Now, John Dees, my minister and best buddy, is telling me at church Sunday that if I got a problem I want to discuss, I need to talk to an empty chair.
If you can't go to that person, just pretend that person's there and get it out.
Yeah, there are. And you know what? It's funny. I had someone just recently come and sit in my office and do just that. Speak to an empty chair just like that. I've done it myself.
Wait a minute. You telling me somebody
write a letter
came into your office and talked to an empty chair while you're sitting in there?
Yeah, no question. Yeah, absolutely. And
what kind of people we got going to our church?
It helped that person. It helped that person. But you know
what?
Does
it matter what kind of chair it is?
Yeah, it doesn't matter what kind. We used a music stand the other day. Listen to Jamie. What kind of people do we have? Well, that right there, what Jamie
bad
just,
people, I'm there.
I was going to say, what Jamie just said is exactly right. What kind of people do we have? You know what? We got people, and we got folks who need to sit and talk to them. The empty chair thing is a method that you can use. If you can't go to that person, can't say, or it's not a possibility. Sometimes somebody needs to talk something like that about a parent that's departed or someone like that. They can't, but they just got to get it out of their system.
All right, and you brought up a good point today. When you go and you say you've done this to, and you apologize to a person you think you may have offended over the years, and if they don't accept it, or they, you know, they treat you like a jerk or
right,
something,
right, sure.
You're just supposed to turn the other cheek and walk away without slapping them.
Well, you know, yeah, that's right. That's right. But you know what? You've done your part. That's the key. You've done your part. You know, you offer forgiveness and give forgiveness whether they want to forgive
accept
you or not. Exactly.
I'll tell you what, John.
You know, that's right.
Why don't you take my list
okay.
and you call all these people and say, Jamie Cooper's got a problem with you.
Well, first of all, that's not how you apologize to someone.
I don't think the church budget can handle the phone bill.
You know, John, I also noticed you got a little old school.
So how's that?
You said send a letter.
Yeah, do people do that anymore?
Write a letter.
Yeah, that's right. That's right.
Hey, that's why the post office lost $8.5 billion last year.
I guess so. I still send letters, but I don't guess many people do.
I used to send a bunch of them. I sent a bunch of them to you. I've kind of gotten out of that habit.
You did.
But the main thing is, John, and people don't do is take responsibility for your own actions.
Boy, that's right there is everything. If we would just take responsibility for our actions, and in the area of apology, that's a huge thing too, the area of apology, because, you know, a lot of times we'll go to somebody and say, listen, I want to ask for forgiveness. I was really, but you know what, the reason I did it is because you were so sorry. We won't really own the thing. When you offer an apology, don't worry about putting the other person on the spot and making them feel bad about what they did. Just own what you did and let it go.
All don't right. you just like it
You're
when someone apologizes quickly? Isn't that nice?
Yeah, that's really nice when they just get it done and get it over with.
Yeah.
You know? Say, hurt people hurt people.
Boy, it's the truth. It's the truth. And one of the reasons we hurt a lot of other people is because we're hurt. And one of the reasons that this is so important, the forgiveness issue, is because if we hurt somehow deep inside, we're going to end up hurting people that we don't even intend to hurt. We're going to hurt other people that we actually love. And it's because hurt people indeed do hurt people. So,
all right, this was my first words I broke down. You got the first thing on here. Why do we forgive those who hurt us? All right, and here was my answer. Good question.
Good question. You know, and Jamie, the only reason I teach anything. Yeah,
good question. I ain't making it up. Good question.
There you go. The only reason I teach anything that I teach is I'm there to teach God's Word. And like I said at the very beginning, I held up the Bible and said the only reason any of this makes any sense at all is because God told us to do it. It's not John Dees telling anyone to do anything. It's what God has to say. And that's why you come and sit on the front row every Sunday morning.
Well, it ain't working.
You'll apologize to me later for that one.
I doubt it.
And I knew during Sunday's message that we were going to have a
lively debate here on the program.
You'll lose.
And thank you, ladies, for going 100 miles out of the way to get here this morning. So y'all stand by. I'll get to you in a second. All right, John, let's switch subjects. Let's talk a little football. What about Auburn playing A&M next year?
Well, you know, I'll leave that up to the powers that be. I mean, A&M's going to get $500,000 check, so it's a good thing for A&M.
All right, you going to get $500,000?
I think so, something like that, yeah.
All right, let's talk about who you going with in Auburn. Obviously, you're going to pick them. I guess you're going to stick with that.
Sure.
Yes.
I'm picking Auburn to win every game.
There you go.
I don't know what happens when I pick them.
That's right.
What do you think about the Alabama-Arkansas game? What's it going to come down to?
Oh, I think Arkansas will be a tough foe, but Alabama will win that game.
Well, you know, Arkansas is like second or third in the nation in passing offense. Yeah. Alabama's second, third in the nation on passing defense.
What a defense Alabama has.
Man, let's talk about the number one thing happening right now in football, though, realignment of conferences. Missouri,
Yeah.
Are they coming?
That's what I'm hearing. I'm hearing the same.
And Auburn's going to go to the Eastern Division?
That's what I'm hearing. I don't know if I like all that, but, you know, hey.
We ain't got a vote in it.
Yeah, that's exactly right.
The Southeastern Conference, University of have informally agreed, this is in Huntsville Times this morning, barring new development, the school will join the league and Auburn will move to the SEC East Division.
Huh. So we'll pick up.
The SEC denies there's any agreement yet.
Okay. But we'll pick up St. Louis and Kansas City TV markets. Is that
right? And we'll pick up the Texas market also.
Yeah. So it's you know, people that know more than I do, you know about it. Nobody's called me about it.
All right. Let's go back to Auburn a little bit here on PETA.
Yeah.
PETA, not only is PETA on to Auburn, but they're wanting to start a pornography site. That's in USA Today this morning. So we're thinking about setting up one here.
Frank's already
agreed to bear his whitey tatties. Frank, you in.
No, he said he doesn't wear briefs.
All in.
No, Frank's once in, always in, Frank.
Frank's all in.
Hey, Frank, don't get on my list.
Frank's all in, baby.
Don't get on my list of those who harmed me in the past, okay? Ain't gonna be on it.
Okay.
But anyway, PETA saying Spirit, you know, he flew into the skybox.
Yeah.
And then regained consciousness and went
sure
all around. But they're saying that he shouldn't be doing that. Well, if they're gonna do that, well, they always try and top the circus.
Oh, yeah. Mm-hmm. Okay, stop the circus, Bevo from Texas.
Don't go fishing.
You know, or the how about Mike the Tiger?
Yeah.
And on and on. And you know, those, like Tom mentioned the other day, those birds, they do incredible things for those birds down there. Nancy used to work, my wife used to work in the vet school and would be close to those birds. It's amazing how much they take these injured birds and do incredible things with them. And an eagle's meant to fly.
Like Clem Tyre here, their son, it goes to Auburn. And he works with them. He was actually, I've told the story before, he was actually in Alaska, I think, for 3 months this past summer, working up there with the eagles and stuff.
Yeah.
What an amazing opportunity.
It is. It's an amazing
It looks
thing.
Like to me people want to complain about anything, John.
You know, that's the beauty of America. We're an affluent nation, and we got time and energy to sit around and complain about nothing.
Tony, where'd the guy call from this morning, Decatur?
Someone in Decatur said he's an All-American white boy, too.
Yeah, and I was talking about being
Minority
nowadays. All white boys like me, seem like us. And he said he
You're
was, too.
Class
Thank
all
you
by
for
yourself.
Watching.
There's no doubt about that.
Oh, by the way, let me remind y'all, each and all of y'all again, we are digital now. We have four channels of ZTV currently running the same thing, but coming up before long, you'll be able to get us crystal clear even further out from Athens.
I talked to several people that I had to help them rescan their television set, walk them through that. So if you hear of anyone who can't get us anymore, tell them to do that.
Yeah, just rescan your TV and you can pick us up digital now with RTV, soon to be adding more programs. And John, Gloria watched her first Rifleman episode yesterday.
There you go. That was
how popular was that show?
It was an awesome show.
What about Daniel Boone?
Daniel Boone was awesome too.
How'd his thing go?
Daniel Boone was a man, was a good man.
Oh, boy.
And I watched something about him. Anyway, it was great.
Daniel Boone.
That's right.
Watch it all right here
Chuck
on RTV on V.
I'm used to better stuff.
Thank you, John.
What? Hey, speaking of PETA, this little dog is being wonderfully treated right now. There you go.
Zorro's having another wise investment by the Cooper family.
There you go.
Thanks to the Stiles family.
Yeah. It's a beautiful little dog. That's great.
All right. Thank you, John. See
you
Sunday morning. Watch John serve us here. We about probably move John here before long. long till 7 o'clock on Sunday night, 7 and 7. That'd be okay with you.
That's fine.
You'd have to sign off on it.
That's right.
What we're
going
to be talking about this Sunday? Are we done with this? We still going?
We're done with the forgiveness, but we're going to talk about how to stay on track and not get off track.
Well, I got to stay on track to call all these people.
There you go.
Right. All right, we're going to get out of here for this Wednesday morning. Coming up tomorrow, Bob Labby joins us. Coach Alan Creasy with Athens. Boy, Bob Jones is on fire, aren't they?
They really have a fine ball club.
Woo-wee. All right, we got to go for now. We'll see y'all bright and early tomorrow morning.
Bye-bye.